Oh, that is Calvin calling me back.
Hello.
What's up, bruh?
What up?
You in the vlog, bruh?
Huh?
I said you in the vlog. I'm vlogging right now. You just called me.
Alright.
Tell them to subscribe and get more subscribers. To get more subscribers. To get more subscribers. To get more subscribers.
Like, share, subscribe. Start over. Like, share, subscribe, share, subscribe, and share.
And like.
And comment. And like, and share, and comment, subscribe.
Right.
Who we vlogging about?
I was just telling them about how I'm not going to switch the car and get a $70,000 car. And instead, I'm going to use that money to invest into real estate.
There we go.
Like somebody who actually has sense.
There we go. I like that.
Right. So what?
You should just got an M3 from the beginning. Shut up, nigga. We won't make it over here.
Bro, you're getting blown, bro. As soon as I tune this car, bro, you're getting blown, bro.
Oh, okay.
Blown.
I believe you.
Bro, meet me at the quarter mile track, bro. Bro, meet me at the quarter mile. Meet me at the quarter mile track, bro.
Do not do drugs at work, bro.
Quarter mile track. Bro, you the one to be taking fentanyl at work, bro. You be stealing fentanyl from the workplace. From the workplace, bro.
Need staff at the losses, bro. Staff at the losses.
Bro, you tripping right now, bro.
For everybody that don't know, guys, I've been trying to wean D off of crack cocaine since we started this channel. It has not been working.
Whatever. I've been trying to tell Calvin that car is only fast above like 150 miles an hour, therefore useless in like any situation in life ever, except for like
Does that explain why you keep getting walked?
Bruh. Only on a freaking airstrip are you gonna be able to beat me once I tune the car, bro. An airstrip, bro. Bro, we are gonna have to go to Hartsfield-Jackson, bro. Hartsfield-Jackson is the only place you're gonna be able to beat me, bro.
If we launch from anything, there's not a dead stop, you're gonna get walked.
Bro.
If we launch from 60, you're gonna get walked.
So yeah, what's up, y'all? D, no, we'll drive. I was just jamming out. Came back on, sorry. Love Outkast, favorite artist. But so was jamming out, way home from work, decided to make a video to update you all on the S5 situation. What am I gonna do with it? Am I gonna get rid of it? What am I gonna get next? What's going on? So I'm gonna let y'all know what the deal is. It's rainy outside, so I have a hood on. It's a very ugly day in Georgia, super ugly. But basically, this is what the story is. You heard a little snippet of it when I was talking to Calvin just then, but I've been really thinking about it and weighing options, looking at everything, just looking at every single thing, and I think I'm gonna keep the car, but here's why. Kind of a totally different direction than before, but when I got to thinking about it, I'm like, $70,000 for a car is a lot. And I didn't really see one much better than the S5. Because keep in mind, guys, the S5 is still under warranty. Like, it's not like if something were to break, it's like not under warranty. I just probably shouldn't tune it. But, like, there's no reason to rush out of it. So I'm thinking, I'm like, the money it's going to take to get out of it, and then the down payment on that car. And then if I were to get the Z06, then that's not really practical to drive every day, so I have to get another car. And I'm just like, is the Z06 really worth all that money? I'm like, that money can be much better spent doing something else. And one of the subs actually commented, I should have wrote his name down, I forgot, but he was like, he didn't say you should invest it, but he was like, you should like not spend $70,000 on a car. He was basically like, you know, I make probably way more than you, he probably does. And he was like, I still wouldn't buy a $70,000 car. And this is true. And I was like, I could do it. And I could easily do it. But, like, it's not like I would have to be eating McDonald's every day or, like, stressing out. Like, you know, it wouldn't really, because like I say, it wouldn't really be much more than I pay a month now. You know, do it easily. But, the sheer capital and cash of the down payment it would take and the little bit to get even on this car can be used with something much better. So, with that being said, I actually have an opportunity came up recently in the past couple of days for me to purchase some real estate, purchased some rental properties at a really good price. So turns out one of my family members actually, well, like by marriage, so you know, I didn't really know him too well. I mean, of course I knew him, but I never like really sit down and talk to him. But I've always noticed that like he doesn't really work that much, and I kind of always wondered like, how do you not work that much? So I got to talking to him, and he was like, yeah, I have like 5 rental properties, or was it 6? He has like 5 or 6 rental properties. And so he was just telling me about it, and I was asking him questions, because like I said, I've been thinking about getting into it. So long story short, he basically convinced me to get into it, and even gave me, you know, kind of a plug on a place to get a couple of properties for like, you know, below value, like pretty good price. So I'm gonna use that money, with a little bit more obviously, but I'm gonna use that money instead in a much smarter way and get a couple of rental properties. I'm gonna start out with just one, probably here pretty soon, and then get another one maybe by the end of the year. So I think you all will agree this is a much better use of money, because like I say, there's nothing wrong with the S5. I would much rather have an S5 and 2 rental properties bringing me money every month than a Z06 costing me money every month, costing me tires. Because I know myself, I probably go through like a tire, like a set of back tires a month in a Z06. So, you know, I would much rather just kind of wait things out, get those properties, have them doing cash flow. And I kind of really want to get into it, because now that he kind of broke it down for me and he saw, or he helped me to see, you know, really how easy it is to kind of build passive income that way, gonna start doing that. And then, you know, in a year or two, your boy might be in a hurricane. But yeah, so that's the direction I'm gonna go now. I'm gonna keep the S5 and instead use that money for real estate. So, you know, maybe we can kind of slightly turn this to a real estate channel, because I'm gonna, you know, update you all and update you guys and let y'all know how it's going. So we're gonna do that. Also, follow my logic here. I may still tune the car. Let me know if y'all want me to still tune it. Here's why I'm not as afraid about the oil thing. A, I read and I searched about APR tune, could not find a single horror story about the tune causing anything on the car to go wrong. Y'all correct me if I'm wrong, like I challenge all of my followers, all of my subs rather, to find a story of an APR making an S5 go to crap. Can't find one. This engine is pretty, it can handle the tune. Like, they were under tuned from the factory. Like, it can handle it easily, especially with the stick. Nothing's gonna go wrong. The oil consumption issue, the guy said there might be a problem, but there might not be. You know what I'm saying? The slave cylinder, I really looked it up, and even had the car not been under warranty, a slave cylinder costs $170. So it's not like that would have been warranted spending more than $10,000 total to get out of the car. You know what I'm saying? Also, suppose everything went to crap and the engine blew. Suppose that happened, which the oil consumption, really the only thing that would cause that would be the rings. But other than that, literally any other issue and probably the whole engine won't blow, right? But let's put the whole worst case scenario. Let's say it does. You can get a used engine for this car for about $6,000, which is less than the pure capital that it costs, would cost right now to get out of it and to get into something better. So basically, it's definitely spend that money now to get out of it and get something better. Definitely spend probably about $12,000 in pure capital, if not more. Or keep the car, and maybe in a year or two, there's like a maybe 5, less than that percent chance that the total engine goes to crap, and I'd have to get another one for $5,000. But, you know, that's less than the opportunity cost of getting out of it now, and then getting into these opportunities that may not be there, and to have that positive cash flow coming in. So, I mean, you know, we're talking rental properties, tenants already in them, guys. You know what I'm saying? So, can't pass this opportunity up. So, that is an update on the S5. So we're keeping the S5, and we may still tune it. So you guys let me know what you think about this latest development. Bad idea, good idea? Let me know. But this is just an update. D, No Will Drive 229, like, comment, share, subscribe, share, subscribe, and share and subscribe. And y'all have a good day. More content to come. No Wheel Drive.